This is how whale watcher Wayne Reynolds views the world most days, staring down his mega lens for that one magic moment rising from the deep. And yesterday it happened, a rare blue whale surfacing off Cape Solander just south of Sydney in all its glory.
I scanned in on it and I thought it was a little bit big, and when it popped up I just thought, oh, it's not humpback. And when it actually showed up, I thought, oh God, it's a bluey, and I just yelled out, ran up, grabbed some more film and basically let go.
In his own laid-back way, Wayne got excited, after all.
It's not every day you get a blue whale hanging off Sydney, so nah, that's pretty good.
Bluey's cameo appearance had uncanny timing, coinciding with foreshadowed New South Wales government legislation giving whale-watching businesses and leisure craft guidelines to work within.
Don't get too close, don't stay too long, and therefore don't interrupt the natural behaviour of the animals.
Bluey wasn't strutting his stuff today for those hundreds of lenses aimed seaward, but several of his humpback cousins were far less camera shy. This pair taking a leisurely cruise north, coming to within a couple of hundred metres from shore.
The New South Wales government's basically playing catch-up with most of the other states which already have tough whale protection laws in place. It's expected our legislation will be passed in time, though, for the next whale-watching season.
The announcement welcomed by National Parks, sick of the minority of cowboys on the water.
The worst thing that you could do is approach very rapidly from the front with a speeding boat and continually harass the animal. And we have seen some recreational boating activity conducted in that way.
The legislation will also affect seals and dolphins as well as whales. Tim Collins, 10 News.